Test, test. Can you hear me? I think it works. Sorry about that. Not sure what happened. Okay, this is the current state of the mess quarry. We built the roof and the first layer. Everything in between is missing. So that's gonna take so long to finish this. So yeah, let's see if we can maybe... Oh, somebody has been building on this! Nice! Okay, so a bit of progress has been done, apparently. So what was the schematic even called? 720 White Red Mesa Quarry. Must be it. You need to rotate it. Yeah, seems like it. Oh no, just in the back for some reason. It's been a while since I... Yeah, that seems like I need to rotate it twice, I guess. Huge schematic, takes a while. Okay, here we are. Should I add an option to remember schematic locations? I think Messer is actually working on that, so he's making his own schematic or similar program. I think he has that. Yeah, this is literally the worst part. I see the schematic now. It's still wrong somehow? I just need to move it like 40 blocks, okay. Got it. Finally, I'm just gonna write that down, because I did it next time. Yep, I can get rid of Forge. It's also, for me, except replay mode, really the last Forge mode that I'm using. Right, so are those layers completed? Looks like it. Hey drum! Okay, seems like that layer's completed. Just so huge, but I can't wait to start this thing. That's gonna take a while. I think we should maybe make a regular date where I work on the Mesa Quarry, like every Wednesday from, let's say, 6 to 9, we work 3 hours on a quarry. Then eventually we finish it. Okay, so what's that layer? Slime Observer Redstone. cactus? I think it's better if you use the carpet features. Place it directly. Shall we do it? Let's place maybe the redstone block here and lit slime stuff. And then way back the rest. Okay, this is a long question. To play on a whitelist server, I'm trying to get people to play on it again. Place often. Any ideas how to motivate other people to play Minecraft? Not really. I mean, we also have it at the moment. Methods is not really motivated, and also the others, I'm actually mostly alone at the moment. But I'm probably also busy freelance stuff. Oh, that's gonna happen a few times. Oh yeah, also, this Saturday there won't be a marathon livestream. I said it like 2 or 3 weeks ago that we might do it, but just didn't work out. Not a lot of people will have time. Myself, I actually have also something else to do. I didn't manage to finish the stone generator for next perimeter. We're gonna have to delay it. Not sure when. There's a lot of World Cup games also coming up. Maybe just do it in a month. Sorry about it. If it's better for you, it's also good. So I would say we'll probably do it not this weekend, but like 4 weeks later, the next one. So we're not given output by placing helps you out, does it? For sure it does. So I don't need to pay attention that much. Here it wouldn't matter. Just would push down, but yeah. Some cases you would need to work around those issues, and yeah, that's never fun. So Ian said he invited lots of non-technical players to his world. Yeah, we also thought about that, but it's also tricky sometimes. If projects like that one need a lot of instructions, or they would get in the way, kinda. I also spent some time today and added 30 songs to the playlist, so it shouldn't repeat this time. Bobby, please don't mess with the auto DJ. I think you selected some Hans Zimmer music yesterday, and then I uploaded it on my second channel, and immediately YouTube complained about the copyright. So this is the problem. Oh yeah, funnily enough, now I have 3 videos on my second channel, but not a single subscriber yet, because I never told anybody. So there's a chance to be the first subscriber, I guess. Yeah, I set up the second channel yesterday. I've got to figure it all out, how to link the Twitch account and the YouTube. Yay, first sub, found it. Okay, nice. I guess you can find it with a YouTube search. Yeah, I'll probably do the redstone blocks afterwards. Just focus on that stuff. I'm just gonna upload my live stream, kind of replays there. And for example, the Zoomer sometimes makes videos that are not really for the main channel. I also thought about that, to sometimes make videos that aren't really for older viewers or just for the main group, more or less. It's just some silly videos sometimes. A few times I actually would have preferred to do that, but yeah, didn't have the second channel. But this might be a good opportunity now. Yeah, I listened to so much music today, just in order to get something that I like a little bit, because I also have to listen to it. Cat reveal when? Next week. Left foot reveal? No. By the way, I never collab with Mamba or Suzuma. I don't know. We actually did a collab with Suzuma. He was on our server once. I think it's kind of hard to get in touch with Mamba, to be honest. Also, I don't really know what to collab with them. Any ideas? Cat collab. Thank you. I don't know, we could maybe show Mumbo some results of our lag tests. Just to what avoid, because I think he has a reputation for lagging the server sometimes, but I'm not sure. When's the next Cycraft server? You really don't know. So projects we have almost finished, kinda, are the Guardian Farm, but I'm still need to make a video about that. And then there's also the Witch Farms, which are also not really finished. And this would also be a server to the Mesa Quarry, but this is nowhere near finished. So it's gonna take a while, I guess. Possible if one chunk is loaded, not spawn using chunk loaders, loads nearby chunks, they all unload. Don't entirely get what you mean there, but no, I really don't get it. The Nether Perimeter will contain some mob farms, but first we need to make it spawn-proof. So, slab floor probably. Oreo was working on actually a more sophisticated floor. I'm not entirely sure what's the plans there. I'm not really involved in that. Then Panic made a Wizard Skeleton farm in the other perimeter we did before. I actually want to build that. So that's probably also one of the next projects. Also server tool material, I guess. We don't have Ultras in the big perimeter, no. Brilliant planning. But I never thought that the XCOM actually would make a 1k by 1k bedrock free area. Hey Matthew. Do you have any build just for fun on the server? What is fun? I mean, I built some decorative builds that don't have any purpose. Like 3 or 4. So what I always wanted to do, because I did it actually in the world before I played on Cycraft, was a horse racing track. I would like to do that again. Maybe an ice boat racing would also be interesting. Maybe with the blue ice, some really high speed ice boat racing, that would be fun. There's obviously also a lot of effort. Tortua, Troll und Gnemmon, Orego. I don't know. This is not what I enjoy. Also, when the Hermicraft is to their pranks, also skip those episodes. That's not really. I don't know. Just don't find that funny or interesting. No, it's okay. You're acting like a 12-year-old. No offense. Yeah, I'm not really into reaction videos. Sorry. How late will I be streaming? 9 p.m. German time. So that's 2.5 hours. Weekly Cycraft, yeah, it's probably not gonna be twice a week forever. I think soon I have to go back to once per week because it's just so much effort to make those episodes. And at the moment I'm really focusing on getting the grindy projects done. I can't do really much YouTube content out of that stuff. German time is the same as Spanish time, yes. We actually thought about setting up a stream for the first quarry in Anessa. But I wasn't entirely sure if this is actually allowed on Twitch. To have just a stream going where the streamer is not there. You have to chat unsupervised, not sure if this is even allowed. Not sure. How big is the Mesa Quarry? It's 720 blocks long. So this is by far the biggest slimestone machine ever built. It's almost 500,000 blocks. And estimated building times are probably 200 hours. Who would you call the best builder in Cycraft? Panic is actually really good. Knows a lot of little building techniques for some reason. Enemy is certainly the fastest builder. He can build grindy projects at an insane pace. He's definitely the fastest builder. Yeah, I agree. It would be nice to have some builders on the server, yep. Who's the worst builder? XCOM. No, he once built an ice tunnel. It was so awful. It was a one wide tunnel, 2 blocks high, and just built out of the random materials he had in his inventory. Netherrack, dirt, stone. Yeah, everybody has different talents. Yeah, Rag was also not much of a builder, but he put some time and effort into it. Also gets some decent stuff done. Who's the funniest person on Psycraft? Oh, there's also a tricky one. Definitely not Rago.
Rago with his puns.
Funny, not annoying. No, Vince has a nice sense of humor, I would say. We actually had a builder division on Psycraft, yes, and that didn't really work out, so not sure if it was the people that weren't really that good, or if just in general you don't get along. So that, I don't know, probably just the wrong people we had there. Who is that called? This is Earth Computer. The RNG Master. Materialist for this on a 500 Y perimeter. Can take the materialist for this one and just can divide it. Loading for 5 seconds. That is insane. It's 130k concrete just for the roof, 90k slime blocks, 60k observers. So many pistons, yeah. A lot of stuff. Will you ever upload a video of another game on your second channel? I have to play another game first. Could be, yeah. I play so much Minecraft, I actually don't want to spend any of my remaining time on video games. Probably even place those diamond blocks down just because we have it, why not? What do you want to do? Steal other people's LP and edit your own commentary over it. Oh, that's smart. Easy content. this is the tweaker room mod we're using here. Or copy client, actually. In order to place those blocks. So once you build enough of those flying machines, actually... Really glad for that. Looks like I'm gonna finish a layer in 1 hour. So this pace, done in 100 hours. Oh, nobody set up jump beacons here. And how does the mod know which orientation is the right one? I actually have to press buttons for that. So if I press the control button, then the observer is gonna face into the slime block. If I press the alt button, then it places the block exactly the other way around, like usually. And if I press, for example, control and alt, it faces away from the block I place it. And with that, you can pretty much do everything. Not everything, but most of it. My sprint key is R. Oh, now we've jumped again. Oof. When I'm done with that build, I'm actually gonna be good at parkouring. Maybe I should just ignore those redstone blocks. Focus on that line. How many layers are done? 7? of 110. Oh, did somebody set up the Nightbot? That is sweet. This quarry design is the one I showed, yeah. Obviously, Pella was also helping a bit making it. It's also based on his quarry. It's not Nightbot? Oh, you did it. Oh, okay. Still need to set it up, yeah. I tried it today. I actually apparently have to download the program for that. And then I was running out of time. I was working on something else. Spent like 2 hours today just searching for music again and... Then a lot of people requested a dirt placing setup for the pot cell farm. That's what I did today. Tomorrow is a video about that. I was also a bit working on the piston bolt today, building stations. Any good seed finders? Looking for something specific? If it's just a Witcher, then XCOM recently was working on one. Yeah. Did you get help from Bizum to name your second channel? No. But I had to look it up myself. I don't speak Italian. But if you would learn another language, I would actually probably either do French or Italian. But I really don't see much of a reason in learning languages. Like the Spanish that I learned for 3 years, yeah, kind of pointless. Why is the channel name in Italian? It's just random. Python is a cool language. True, if I should have learned language, it is actually a programming language. Maybe some Java, so I can maybe also read the Minecraft code. Oh, that stupid slime. I'm actually so tempted to turn off the slow slime. Hey, Robert Man. What coding languages do you know? So I learned a bit of SQL in university and Java. But yeah, not much. Can't really learn that much with one lesson per week for half a year. And then taught myself some Visual Basic, sort of one for Microsoft Excel, writing those macros. And yeah, I don't really think it's a language, but some auto hotkey, so it is also kind of uses a language, yeah. So I got the basics down, I guess. what triggers the whole thing at some point so we don't get a catastrophic launch of the system. Is it supposed to be here? Yeah. We're building the Mesa Quarry today. So I'm basically parkouring around, placing the slime blocks. Would be nice. Is Mesa there? Maybe? Would be nice to have a feature to show two layers at a time for the new schematica. Or three layers, so you can adjust how many layers it displays. But it would be so nice. Okay, got that part. Now it's just the redstone blocks left. Okay, panic confirmed. It's the plan of Skylight Medica. Alright, it's gonna be a big help actually. Because if I would seed it the next layer as well, then could probably do more work in one go. It's probably would help. Layer range. Oh yeah, that's so good. Awesome. Because if I display everything, this is, yeah, that doesn't really help. Would I be wrong in saying the Cycroft Seed Finder no longer works? I really don't know. Never used it. It was laggard thing. If you change the schematic, you show the current layer and those below it. Is that the layer 3 or so? Yeah, I could make a new schematic where I show all these 3 layers. Thinking about that. Maybe for, because it's just repeating over and over again. Once I maybe have the first, I think those are 8 or 9 blocks high. The first module can make a schematic out of that, or I just go into my creative world, but I need to find it first. And I can maybe make 3 layer schematics. Thanks, Jamin, for 10 bits. You can see three layers now if you wanted to. Okay, I have to read that again. If you change the schematic to show the current layer and those below it, you set the layer. Thanks a lot for the sub, Messa. At Matthew was a gift. Thanks a lot, Matthew. Is it schematics for all layers below? Okay, let's check it. That's not it. Where's that option? Layers? Okay, I missed it then. I have an old schematic that I copied, so I don't have that yet. Here, layers. I can select a layer, but not. There's no option here where I could select additional layers. I need to update it. I don't know, is the latest version also for 1.12 flat? Because I have a really old version I copied. Okay, that actually makes me want to update schematic immediately. I'm gonna do it after the stream. Current song is Lonely Dance by... Does he have some kind of a... Do you have a program for that that does that? A song detection program? The most recent release for 1.12.0, okay. Just notes from memory. See, he wrote a script. Okay. Cool. Thanks a lot, Screamly, for the subscription. It's really appreciated. And enjoy your emotes. Okay, one layer done in 1 hour. Sweet. How much material was that? Oh god, it's like 1200 blocks only. That takes an hour to place. Oh god. Okay, what's the next one? Oh, there's also another nice... That is a nice one, actually. How many layers is the quarry? It's like over 100. I think where's layer 100? Yeah, we can definitely see layer 100 here at the top. And there's still some after that. I think it's even 130 or so. Yep. Yeah, one layer per hour, I would take that. That's probably a bit more work, so I estimated it to be 200 hours of work. Where's Rego at? Probably still at work, usually joins around 8 or 9. Stupid slime. Okay, culture was saying again, 1.2, and has it all below option. Yeah, okay, actually write it down. Yeah, thanks. when the next quarry design will come? Actually, we're working on it since, I think, September. So we already know what to do in order to make the quarries much faster again, but it's so much work. I remember that the last quarry, I did that in like a week. But I woke up in the morning, worked on the quarry all day, and went to bed. And did it for a whole week. So that's why I'm kind of burned out of doing that. How much do you sleep a day? 8 hours. Need my sleep. Sometimes 6. Sometimes 10, but yeah, usually 8. Yeah, 4 hours, I don't know. Couldn't keep that up for a long time. Yeah, some people can manage to do, I don't know, function with 6 hours of sleep over a longer time. I don't. When I did a lot of running, I was actually probably sleeping 10 hours a day even. Building a mesa quarry, a fully automated machine that will mine this away. Oh yeah, what we haven't done yet is searching for all the spawners, chests and obsidian that might be in there as well. But this is gonna be semi-cheaty since we probably just need to go to a copy of the world, use spectator mode, fly through it, write down the coordinates and remove that stuff. How do you swap slime and pistons? There's a pick block function for Schematica. Select the normal pick block function, just with blocks that are supposed to be built. Yeah, I do take days off. Not often. Sometimes I'm just busy doing something else, or I just do some minor work. Is taking the time to set up the quarry faster than going through with haste and a couple of people? Yes, multiple times faster. So building the quarry and all little details we need for it, it's probably gonna take 300 hours. But mining all of it would take 3 or 4,000 hours. How long does my workout take? Usually 90 minutes. Any tips? Not really. The worst part is getting into it. But once you do it for 3 months, you have a habit and then it shouldn't be hard to keep it up. But the first 3 months are hard. Same with running. Probably haven't run that much lately. In order to get into running again, probably would take me also 3 or 4 months, which are brutal. And then I could run every day again. Should really try that. third video for the subscriber special. Yeah, next week, sorry. Methods actually is also involved in that and needs help, as he's not online recently. How many blocks per hour? I mean the quarry? No, the quarry is much faster than digging. It's about 200,000 blocks per hour. So it is a lot faster than digging. Thank you. could replace a leaf block as a bridge. Just to give if this is worth it. Because I'm really struggling with the parkouring around this place. Might be worth it, actually. I mean, this would take like 2 minutes to set up, 2 minutes to move afterwards. Should we try it? Maybe next layer? Yeah, let's actually use melon blocks, we don't need to remove those even. No problem with that. Yeah, yeah. Leave for melon blocks. Probably leaf blocks better, because those can't be powered by observers, and I'm not sure if maybe... Who knows, something could go wrong. Yeah, the next layer we're gonna get some leaves. The bed switch is not running all the time. Like the additional mob switch, both require a permaloader currently. And we usually don't have that running. So the beds are not really that much of a distraction in this case. Is strip mining one by one hole an option? No, definitely not. Yeah, I wish there was some way how we could feasibly remove obsidian and chests and spawner blocks. But there really isn't. Obviously the wizard would break some of that stuff. But yeah. It's not an option. How many diamonds will this mine? Zero? It's too high. We're above the diamond level. So we mostly do it for the what's it called? Clay or terracotta now. And because it's cool and we want to do it. Also, we're getting a lot of dirt from it, which is also nice. And some ore blocks, technically also nice. Yeah, no, for all of those auto stops and a signal, but this is not easy, and it would make it really slow. Then you still need to search for it. So, yeah, not really an option. Yeah, uploading the streams is really convenient. Just press on a video on Twitch and send export and it immediately uploads it. Also at the moment no YouTube ads because I didn't monetize the channel yet. We'll do it once I figure out if how much of a problem are those songs? Because technically, I would need to mention every single song that I use now and mention it in a YouTube video. That's definitely not fun. The largest quarry is 720 blocks wide. And the area here that is getting mined is about, I think, 90 blocks high. Put an overlay with the, oh yeah, if we would have the program that does that, then there should be enough. Yeah. So I look into getting that to run again. Today I didn't have the time anymore. Sorry if I missed the question. How long is the quarry? 720 blocks wide. Not sure what I mean with long. Probably the same. How many chunks will it go? Oh, you mean the distance it travels. So it could go infinitely, but we probably stop it after 3,500 blocks. What's my favorite game other than Minecraft? I really had a lot of fun with the Breath of the Wild Legend of Zelda game. Also, I loved Mario 64, it was a great. Subscription by Squealy Dev. Thanks a lot. Finally, Mesa Quarry. Yeah. I actually want to make this a regular thing. Every Wednesday from now on, 6 to 9, 3 hours working on a Mesa Quarry. And then at least we will finish it at some point. Yeah, this would definitely help if I get the leaves. Definitely after this layer I'm getting some. Save some time. But we can already see the end, so maybe 200 blocks. What speedrun games do you follow? I follow Ocarina of Time. A guy called ZFG is streaming it. And yeah, Super Mario Bros. And some Mario 64 for the old Nintendo games. I died about 280 times. Yeah, Minecraft speedruns also don't like those. They're really not that interesting. Yeah, I saw the cheese speedrun world record, yes. Not live, but on YouTube. Yeah, this is a great game for speedrunning. Really fun to watch. Could the quarry be stationary and some flying machines would just get the blocks to it? I don't understand the question. You mean... No, I don't understand it, sorry. What project are you most proud of? Probably this quarry here, actually. Wasn't easy. Can we see your Cycroft statistics? Actually getting asked like almost every stream. Yeah, can maybe take a look at it. So just search for your favorite statistic. Time played. Guess at some point I'm gonna crack the year. It was actually funny, last time in stream somebody said he has 1.7 years played on the same map. Also quite insane. Yeah, a lot of distance covered. Number of deaths, 292 already. Okay, like one death per day. Mob kills. Yeah, Gnemon already has 80 million. But I also killed some guardians. Player kills 53. Yeah, sometimes Rego got in the way. And items enchanted, 0. Plocks mined. Almost 5 million stone. Sweet. Times use, so placed. Yeah, most was iron blocks. So we had 1 million iron blocks at some point, so yeah, it's not surprising that we kind of used those up if I already placed them myself almost. Then crafted, it's bone meal probably, traded emeralds, yeah, not too interesting, and some mob kills. Okay. What program do you use for your auto-clicker? Auto-hotkey, usually. But lately, I'm just using Messers. Inbuilt option from Tweakaroo. It's been a while since I used auto-hotkey, actually. And don't plan to do it that often anymore. Use auto hotkey professionally, yeah, could imagine that. When I did my internship, also used it a lot. Company request denied the request to use auto hotkey. Okay. That's probably not a good decision. This definitely makes a lot of stuff more efficient. Could probably replace entire jobs probably. No, we won't use any RNG mob farms. we probably use RNG manipulation to manipulate ore drop rates, the weather, and that's pretty much it. But not for spawning. Auto hotkeys sort. The company thought auto hotkey was too cheaty, yeah, not vanilla.
Hey ho.
Hey Ragu. Yeah, with weather I meant lightning. Kind of part of the weather for me. Okay, let's get some leaves.
Hello.
Hey, Panic. RNG for leaf generation of hot soul. Yeah, resub by Eli J. Charles. Thanks a lot for the 2 months resub. Yeah, I don't know if you should use it for too much stuff. I mean, obviously you can use it for hundreds of things. No, no, maybe not hundreds, but dozens of things. And it's also quite some effort to set it up all the time. And since it doesn't work anymore, I'm up at 13. Probably shouldn't overdo it.
Yeah, it would definitely be a cool project to convert all the diamonds ores to diamonds with the machine, but other than that...
Yeah, obviously the lightning strikes for the creeper farm, mobhead
farm. Yeah, that's something... just to have it in 1.12 and 1.13, it's getting easy as fuck, so...
Yeah. At some point, I'm gonna remember where to go. It's my spot. Messed up.
Left.
Ah, piston bolt. No?
I don't know how much delay there is, but you should just turn around.
Yeah, now I'm on my way.
Now at least what's on the stream, you're in the right direction. A bit more to the left, but...
Somebody requested the mango song again, was this Bobby? No? Somebody got it in my playlist, okay. Going on.
Oh, I was going through a bottle probably.
Oh yeah, got some legs back here. I hope you didn't select a 10-hour version. No, 1 minute, okay. Who wants the next 2 hours of Mango Song?
Me!
Enemy.
Yeah.
Leaves.
Me, because I have the stream muted.
Same.
Yeah, that's a good thing, being in voice chat, right?
Okay, I think 4 boxes... Kinda expensive, and I don't know how to operate the farm, so... Yeah, let's get 6 boxes. That That's a problem for future Mango. Yep. Now for something we actually needed like 50k leaves, so it was like, oh yeah, the mob farm!
Yeah!
Okay, we need to farm some leaves, I guess, since we raised them here for the quarry.
Didn't XCOM work on this, like, improved one or whatever?
Yeah, but is he gonna build it? Or does it
not
actually
sure,
work?
But if it's working and finished, someone else can build it.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, XCOM tests and survival, so yeah, probably not.
Yeah, it's probably better here to allow song requests. First of all, copyright, and sometimes like 50% of just some kind of a meme song you have to skip then. It's not a good idea. It should be here, right? Load.
Oh, now that I'm at the sandstone perimeter, I remember I made a stone creeper statue. Wanna take a look at it?
Yeah. You can immediately travel back.
No, it's on the creative server, that's what I meant.
Oh, yeah. Northeast, okay. I have to log out anyway since my Elytra doesn't work. Okay. Sweet, that's why you're the best builder on the server. Awesome.
Yeah, it's weird. I first built a creeper as a pixel art, and then I had those steps towards the stone creeper.
Yeah, that is sweet.
Yeah. I don't know what to build above it. Didn't have much time, so.
Well, we could just keep the same on top, right?
Yeah, maybe.
I was thinking maybe you can put something in the triangles on top. Some neat little decoration or like some lettering or whatever.
Actually, we use the creeper because the pillars don't line up. Or yeah.
Yeah, the middle is weird.
That's why we want to build a creeper or anything
should
in the middle.
Put a creeper on each side, or should we also put the other mobs?
Yeah, I thought maybe the other mobs as well, but
skeletons,
I think they get too big. Yeah, skeletons are pretty thin. And
so we would have skeletons
high, probably.
Zombie and witch.
So, yeah, that's the only four mobs we get. Would be cool. You could maybe copy the witch we already have at the witch farm. At the
storage. Yeah,
I think that one is higher, right?
With no.
With the head and everything.
No, it's exactly one block per pixel. But it should be a bit higher than with
the head.
Yeah, in general, the other mobs will be higher than the creeper, right?
Hmm.
Yeah, I guess we could in the top just make like a half dome thing, like a sphere roof-ish thing.
Yeah, just make it higher and then
it's
we
higher,
can,
right?
Yeah, all mobs fit under it. Yeah, I can work on that.
Nice. Hmm. Why is the creeper not green? I think actually it's a good idea that it's out of stone. Better than
Mango doesn't like colors anymore.
Yeah, you can take a look at the green creeper on the left side that I first built, and that doesn't fit really.
No, I prefer the
stone. It would have finally some contrast, so Mango doesn't like it.
Just to hear what chat says, which creeper is the best. I like the gray one the best.
Maybe the middle one. Like a bit of white kinda adds to it. The other one looks a bit pale.
Yeah, change the white with a diorite, I think. Yeah. Have it a little more stony because, yeah, well, in the statue, those white dots didn't quite fit in my opinion.
Yeah. I think the overwhelming majority is also for the right one. But I kinda influenced them as well because I already stated my opinion. Yeah, I think we keep that one. Yeah. All right, let's get back to quarry building.
Okay.
enemy.
Yeah.
What the fuck are you clicking?
I have this key switch tester with like different kinds of key switches for my new. Just trying to decide which key I would like for my new keyboard. You probably can hear the clicky ones.
Would you like a pole for a creeper? No, I think I wouldn't like to build the other two options anyway. And the majority was for the gray one. Okay, loading schematic again.
Dictator, mango, ill.
So should I stick to the stone? So for example, the skeleton would be whiter than the stone normally, but a stone skeleton would also look nice.
I'm not trying to get the noisiest or most annoying key, but the click sounds nice, to be honest. It feels nice as well. The feel is an important thing.
No, this layer also requires some scaffolding. Let's check it out. Not sure what to do. Where should we place the walking bridge? In front, I guess. On the left, yeah, in front of the pistons. Because if you would put it in the back here, then there's a sticky piston, then we lose those, and that's probably best on the left, yeah.
But if it's a walking bridge, does it even matter? Can't it walk where it's needed?
Do you ever listen to yourself, Rayu?
Yeah, usually I do.
Not to pull up anyway. Really?
Lol.
Oh, wrong placement mode. Okay. There we go. Oh, a question. Is Tuesday, Friday, Sunday schedule listed below an exception? Or is the stream exception? Actually, I don't follow my schedule. But at some point I just read that you need to have a schedule in order to get partnered with Twitch. So then I'll just make one, roughly try to keep it up, but yeah. Schedule's overrated.
Usually he's just lying to you, don't worry.
So we definitely agreed on every Wednesday, as much as it's possible on Wednesday, I'm gonna build from 6 to 9 German time on the Mesa Quarry, 3 hours. every Wednesday from now on. That's for sure.
That's your schedule.
Yeah. But I don't focus completely on streaming, also do my YouTube stuff. That's why it's kind of hard to keep up the schedule. Yeah, this is the Mesa Quarry for mostly terracotta, some dirt gold, yeah. Could we make an RNG manipulator to always get the max XP from enchanting bottles? That'd be pretty cool.
You're the only one who uses enchanting bottles in this entire game. Like,
why?
Because no one uses them.
Probably not possible, though.
Not possible, okay.
Probably.
I guess we probably even need multiple leaf walking bridges per layer. Because this definitely makes a lot of sense.
And the nice thing about them is, since they get crushed automatically, you can just leave them behind.
Oh, building like that is actually... it's gonna even itself out. And it's okay, I guess.
Very good, it's time to stop.
Kills the bridge.
Why?
Yeah. But it's not a big deal. Come on! So if you would have another bridge here, then this placing that stuff might be easier. Okay, now let's fully commit leaf bridges. Next one. Bye, Earth. Yeah, so we're making walking bridges now. This is, might be more efficient than my parkouring attempt, my poor parkouring attempts. So here we actually need a scaffolding anyway, kinda. So it's probably a really good idea. Yeah, we can completely ignore those thief blocks, so we don't need to move them afterwards. Easier to get crushed or left over. Don't seem to care about the leftover leaves. Yeah.
As I said, you can just leave them behind.
Yes. Okay, the leg spike fell off.
And hey, gone.
Rego should leave. That was a good one.
Yeah, but that's what Mango is already doing. He's blazing all of them.
Hey. And that's the reason why.
Also, don't expect any like real big inventions in the stream. We care about people watching, so we don't want to have anything groundbreaking here.
Hi, Alessandro.
Yeah, don't break me, please.
Oh my gosh.
Wait, he just joined for that one? That was awesome.
Okay, I would say we place the first pistons here and then the observers from the other side if this is possible. Let's try. Yeah, it's probably the best way to do it. Wondering why is there no orange glass block in front? Where is that? Where's the next? Okay, this is something else apparently. Still part of the first slice. To be honest, I don't know anymore at all how this quarry works.
This is the part that activates the flying machine.
Yes. Yeah. True enemy. Yeah.
I didn't even build the thing.
Just have a terrible memory. Really? All those bridges still fall down? No, this is not worrying. I mean, how could I remember every little detail about this thing? Especially if something now wouldn't work with the slimestone logic on top, we would have a serious issue because that was just such a mess.
At least you might can remember what you did after it failed. Imagine me building Palace Quarry. Had no idea what everything did.
Yeah, but Palace Quarry is kind of simple compared to this.
Yeah, of course, of course.
Especially the pushing forward part, this is so ridiculous.
But I literally had no idea at all how that quarry worked at the beginning, and then while building it, kind of got that thing pushes the grapples down, that thing moves that forward and so on, but yeah. If the logic or anything would have failed, I hadn't would have had no idea how to fix anything.
Thanks, Jamin, for 10 bits. Try jumping. This is actually what I did try to prevent the bridges. So where should I jump to? Jump to the piston. Oh yeah, okay, I could actually do that.
No, you can't. You fall. Bad at this.
Yeah. So what did we build those leaves again? For what?
Because you're bad at jumping.
Hello? There we go.
Jumping messes with your coordination. Well, then he has to be con used to it.
This is not even. Oh, we're out of slime sticky pistons. I think we have a ton of normal pistons instead, yeah. Probably a lot faster walking, because then I can't miss those jumps all the time. I'll take it back. Yes, last Kardax. Oh, that's good advice from Vilzy. Thanks. Said to not press sprint when jumping. Actually, yeah, that's perfect. This must be so annoying when you fall down all the time. Thanks, Drum, for 20 bits. Thanks a lot after Lemon for another 10 bits. We appreciate it. Thanks. We should just load some schematic chunks here. Poseidon.
If you had built a second bridge one block closer to the observers, you could just place them against the bridge and then do the pistons afterwards. It would have been way easier.
I'm kind of worried that they would mess with the observers.
The leaves decay.
True, would have mattered. Okay, I'll take it back. Yeah, it would have been better.
There's plenty more to build.
It would be nice if you could finish this layer in the stream. 3 hours, three layers would be... Yeah, I'll take that. What's the primitive for? Yeah, the resulting primitive won't be used for anything. Like, very likely.
We'll find something. Fish farm.
Fish farm. No, it's about getting those resources. Just loaded a ton of chunks. What's going on? It's the Mesa Quarry. So, where's the first Mesa Biome here? There we have it. I think over 10 million terracotta blocks will be harvested here. a mind up. Thanks, Strom, for 50 bits. Thanks a lot. Yeah, we did craft a bit over a double chest of notch apples. It's the same quarry design, yeah, showcased. It's just 720 blocks wide, so this will be a ton of work to build. So we're probably looking at another 100 and, I don't know, 50 hours of building it. If nothing goes wrong. Yep, 150 hours. But now we've done several projects that take over 100 hours, so it's not new for us. Oh, thanks a lot for 100 bits now, Rum. Why do I always load it? Just to make sure. Just kind of make sure that it make few mistakes. Obviously it's every serve block and I technically don't need it, but at least it reduces the amount of failures even more, I guess. Mistakes, not failures. Mistakes. Oops. Have you planned when you will start the quarry for the first time? No. When it's done, it's done. The piston placement is assisted by a mod. I'm pressing shift, that means I place the observer facing into the next block, or I place it against. Control, not shift, yeah, control. We're not entirely sure how we do the chunk loading yet. Maybe just some carpet mod boards would be the easiest. Since it's also on a diagonal of the world, Yeah, thermal loading be a problem. Yeah, I guess alt would also work, yeah. Not of the last one. This time I can actually turn off the schematic. Out of observers.
That new piston bolt that goes to the witch hut, the giant one, constantly suffocates me when I drive it.
Play Mario.
Like what? What's in that bolt?
Oreo tried to make it as dark as possible and now it suffocates you.
What the fuck?
Yeah, because it has blocks directly above the pistons, and when you're sitting in a minecart, you drive below those and then you suffocate every block.
Oh, wow.
In which one?
The dark one that goes to the giant witch hut storage.
You can put up regen beacons for it.
Yeah, it doesn't kill me, but I take damage and that's annoying, right?
Yeah.
Guess he just once again got Oreoed. Since people are putting it up. Happy birthday!
Yeah, happy birthday, Panic.
Thank you, thank you.
Trying to roll it off on others.
Yeah.
Is that a Panic running gag you have in the stream or what?
Yeah, apparently.
It's always your birthday? Birthday. Why is there no birthday stream? Come on.
I will come back to streaming probably next week. Now that I have time again, I'm not ill anymore.
Awesome. Recommend those 500 followers.
Oh shit.
You know what I did? If Norwegian reaches 500 followers, we will do a 24-hour live stream.
Oh, he as well. Did you stream lately or what?
Twice.
Oh, okay.
I think now he's gone again. And thanks for the birthday bits. Another 120 bits drum.
Are people actually taking that serious now?
No.
I hope not. Oh, I just realized you have to spawn proof those mobs that I'm building at the moment.
Technically,
that would look
no.
Ugly.
Technically, no. Quite sure.
Okay, yeah, so they're outside of the range, right?
It could be close in some cases. Hmm. But you can always put some, I don't know, some carpet on top or whatever.
Yeah, or just light it up somehow.
Oh yeah, lights would also work, yeah. Just a small chance in my slam chunk.
Yeah. Trump, Mango and Panic have their birthday on the same day. What a coincidence. Yeah, guys, we realized that just yesterday. I really hope that no one has his birthday today and watching a stream here.
200 people in a stream here, yeah, this is probably... Somebody has a birthday, yeah. No, actually no. No, it's just...
It's extremely likely.
It's extremely likely that some people have birthday on the same day, right? That was it.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
The other yeah because it's not a set date, because it can be any date. Yeah. That's why the probability is too high.
If you have like...
25 people, you have a 50% chance that two have their birthday on the same day.
Yeah, but it's
day.
Similar out of magnitude that someone's birthday at that day. Actually, pretty much the same, could just be like one person offset, so.
After 11, thanks a lot. Just gonna check, was it a resub? No. Thanks a lot.
Whoa. Should we make Mango confused again?
Is it a gift? Thanks.
No, not really. Just Twitch Prime.
Okay. Actually, this all would take longer to do the sub servers. Kinda glad. Okay. That's also easy peasy here. Slime up server. Here we have to do. far behind am I after Cyclops episodes? Pretty much exactly 4 weeks now.
Oh, you're catching up?
Yeah, I've been not recording anything really in the last 10 days.
Okay. Have you made an episode about the mob farm?
Yeah. The founders of Cyclops, do they still play? Rego is the founder of the server. I think by now pretty much the second oldest active member. Helvins is also still around, so technically he's the second oldest active member, but always takes breaks of half a year or so.
Isn't Refog a really old member as well?
Yeah, kinda.
Yeah.
Came back a few weeks ago, right?
But I don't think he played.
I don't think he was on the server. So.
He's not, probably not even whitelisted anymore. At some point just cleared the list. I mean, he wasn't active for 2 years and cleared the list.
Wow. Hey, what about Nesim?
I heard from him 1 week ago.
Yeah.
So he met Cube Hamster recently.
Oh, nice.
By random chance.
Wow.
He said Cube Hamster is over 2 meters.
Yeah.
They're Dutch. What do you expect?
Yeah, over 2 meters is quite tall. Come on.
Well,
how do you meet someone by accident and know that they are in technical Minecraft community? That's
now Cube Hamster made a face reveal or whatever. So
he
had a live cam when he did the streams.
Ah, okay.
What's in your food? Over 2 meters is not uncommon, what? I think about it.
That can't be
actually,
nice.
No, nobody
that
really that is over 2 meters, except the one. Not close, yeah. But...
Like finding pants must be so annoying. Are usually...
You know, the fear of drowning makes you grow.
Wow.
So why am I not using F to swap between that stuff? I don't know, does it matter which button or key I press? It's just a But my compress. I'm not sure if the F would be better. I can try. Wait, I'm already confused. No, that isn't, that's one work. No, I'm used to the other system. But I'm literally just clicking on the observer with my mouse. I mean, if we have to concentrate if I try to do that. I think I'm sticking to the mouse, sorry. Oh, thanks for 500 bits on this Mr. Eli J. Charles. Came for excellent technical. Minecraft stayed for the puns. Yes, I think it's good to have Rego around. At least some people appreciate his puns.
See? It's punning off.
God.
No, I can't do it. No, this is not a world heater, this will be a quarry for terracotta. So this machine will break all of those blocks and also pack them up in shulker boxes. So you can use them later. It's not just about the block removal, it's actually about the items. We will push blocks forward and just remove the water. We even need, might need to place some blocks, so is it okay? That should be okay. We just, basically, we always push that layer here forwards and push away the water blocks behind it. That way, deal with the liquids. Will you collect all blocks? Might not collect the cobble. Not sure if we should do that with the sponges still. We could make a 100% automatic sponge farm. Basically another Goldberg machine.
Shots fired.
We talked about a lot of stuff. I think the last thing we kind of agreed on was to basically clear a lot of ocean monuments, reset the server, just save our player files with the sponges. So then we kind of put in the normal effort, but don't extend the world files by several hundred megabytes. Not reset, reload. Or reload the backup. Load the backup. Just save the player files, load the server, the waveboffs before exploring. Yeah, but it maybe takes, I don't know, 10 minutes to get from Ocean Monument to Ocean Monument and get a half of a stack to a stack of sponges. So I would say I can get maybe 200 to 300 sponges per hour, so this should be doable. And it's actually quite fun. They actually removed, by the way, the sponge drop of the Browner in Bedrock Edition. So it's not even there anymore.
That's a shame.
Yeah. And it would kind of have justified if we added a sponge drop ourselves at 1.13, but now... Okay, I guess more leaves. Yep. Would you say the technical community makes up less than 5% of the community? Oh.
Probably, yes.
Definitely less. Like, just imagine how many kids are playing the game.
Yeah, probably even less than 1% then.
Yeah.
But I guess a lot of those kids, there are no community really. But the casual community, I don't know. Is this a community?
Nah.
No. Some alignments to go on? No. But I also don't know how many people would consider themselves part of the PvP community. Is that even such a large group? Or the builder community,
yeah,
or the map maker community?
It's a pretty big one. But I think it's fair to say that the majority of people probably are not in any sort of community or not strongly attached to one.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure the most people still play with one or two friends or even alone, just on their own world. Building
just
a small house
build
or something.
Their own bird shacks.
Yeah.
But they also probably build some simple farms. Some tutorial videos have hundreds of thousands of views.
As in making a bit of farmland and maybe a water channel next to it.
Now, for example, my slime farm video has 300,000 views almost. But it's definitely a lot of people that build stuff like that.
Is it a tutorial or?
Yeah.
Yeah, that has a lot of free play for you. Because people go back and watch it again to check on another detail and shit.
I'm quite sure I've seen also farm tutorials that have over a million views.
Yeah, like Darkham's Iron Farms.
Yeah.
Like the original.
Yeah, but still, I don't think they...
Would you call that tech community? Plus, I mean, you need to have some small farms, right?
Yeah, I mean, plus
in the widest
1 million
sense,
out of 75 million active players, not too much.
By the way, I have all four different mobs in stone now, if you want to take a look at those.
I'm just gonna finish placing those leaves and then...
Okay.
Out. When is Panic going to stream?
Probably next week. Maybe Tuesday or so. Clip this answer, oh my gosh, now I have to do it again. No, I was ill the last few weeks and also in May I had basically no time in general. So yeah. I enjoyed the time when I was at home and had some free time.
Okay, I'm not going back. Let's check out Panic Stone monsters.
So, you're already panicking about the 500?
Not really. Yeah.
Yeah, that was really good. But the face is weird of the zombie.
Yeah, the zombie is my least favorite one. General, also the chest of him looks weird because there's not much on it normally, but it's also a mid-gray color, so no.
Looks like he has a beard even.
Yeah, I have to work on the zombie again, I guess.
Yeah, the witch is good. Skeleton also good. The zombies are really a bit weird, yeah.
Yeah.
And they actually look like that. Hmm.
Maybe a little brighter color for the dark color in on the head.
Hmm.
So, what color can we use there that I haven't used already? Sign, yep.
I think the mouth looks a bit odd. Like, I think you need to invert some dark and bright there.
Maybe do a husk instead? Not sure, we don't have any husks spawning at all, but...
We have, or not?
In the farm, no.
Ah, yeah, they need daylight, right? Oh, the skylight. Right, that's, that's the whole reason why we build it in the desert.
I don't know, they kind of look similar, right? I think they don't have sleeves, or is this also for the normal zombie?
The husks just have those cut off or ripped off.
Yeah, they have to
cloth other than that.
Yeah, ripped off.
Pretty much the same.
You don't have a.
And they have a hat.
Somehow. Yeah, they have a hat. Yeah, what is that?
What?
Is it hair? I'm not sure what that's supposed to be.
Oh, Not really sure either.
Does the zombie also have that? No, not really. It's cloth. Yeah, it could be. Like when you wrap a mummy with cloth. Yeah, that could be. Yeah. Alright, let's see. Alright, that's definitely good looking.
Yeah. I don't really find a block that in that that brightness range and is still gray that I haven't used already on the zombie. It's problem here.
Concrete powder? Mm.
You can't place concrete powder mid-air, right?
Yes.
Well, with maybe with string below.
Do the glitch with tall grass.
Yeah, all that.
Dead corals, somebody suggested.
If dead corals would be in 1.12, right?
Mm. Thanks for 10 bits, Jamin.
Actually, the video of Knemben about the dead corals brought me to the idea to make that stone creeper.
Okay.
I haven't really worked with gray colors before, and yeah. After he said that a lot of builders do that, I tried it out.
Yeah, the flower trick definitely works. Concrete powder, yes.
Hey Panic, is your nether farm ready? Is there anything you'd like to improve?
We talked about that yesterday.
Oh my god, I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's finished. Only okay. Have to add a collection basically, or the collection is even done. Only need a shulker box filler.
Yeah.
And yes, I have idea to how to improve it, and yes, Oreo is also trying to improve it. And
yeah, well, yeah, Oreo is always like that.
Yeah, I mean, he has some valid points. That's it's true, but I mean,
no, we're gonna build a farm.
He has so many ideas or so many farms that he's working on at the same time. None of them is really done.
I mean, if you follow the Oreo wave and never get something done.
No. But he's good to have around. Like, he shares some of his ideas. Amazing.
Yeah, of course. I mean, he also helped a lot with my nether farm.
I wish there were some slime walker boots or whatever.
There is.
I know.
Cheap.
There's the cheaty slime walking.
Yeah.
Actually used it all the time.
Oh my god. Cheetah.
Yeah, we actually have to. This, just gonna show it. Enable no slime. Slowdown movement.
Yeah, the name is a little weird. Yeah. But
so you could just run over it and place them like that. It would be so nice when it's cheaty.
What's up? Had an idea what block to use? Thank you.
But I think the slime still slows you down since you're vertically bouncing. It's not perfect.
Mastermind at gravel? Is that an option?
Gravel?
Hmm. What? For me... Yeah, gravel has those dark bits in it that... yeah, that's too much in my opinion. I'm using light gray wool now. Let's see if that works out.
Hello, Haider.
Is that kind of saying twice the same thing? Hello and hi there.
Well.
Last card X, that's a good idea. I mean, first draw go. Let you walk on slime normally. It's kind of cool.
Yeah.
Maybe even for Soul Sand.
Thanks, Damon. Endicide? Try that.
What?
Panic?
Normal Endicide? Yeah, I can try.
Just put it in and decide then.
Oh my god, this guy.
Did you think about nothing else all day, or is this just automatic?
It's pretty much an automatism by now, yeah.
Do you get paid by the pun?
Ah, Andesite is not Andesite, but Stone. What else? Stone 1. 5. So stupid.
Yeah. It's fixed in 1.13.
Well, then we have to replace those eyes.
Yeah.
I think I used that one.
Jamie, dude, you might be right. That's why I'm having a hell lot of fun.
Wait, you have a pun counter in your stream? Tram, that's not necessary, but thanks.
You always get the first pun command in DRAM. No surprise.
Yeah, he's lurking here.
Yes, I was wondering.
Filthy little cheater.
Like 12 minutes left, but definitely gonna finish that layer. Even if it takes longer.
Why? I was promised the stupid Slurm server wouldn't take that long anymore. Now it answers. Holy heck.
Nobody minds if I stream longer. Yeah, actually, I want to do still some bit of sports today.
Oh, cobblestone could work.
work here anyway? No. No flying machine to ride in place block? Not sure. Definitely would make mistakes and then we have to go back and fix those. Not sure if that's a good idea. Yeah, you can try it. Just to see how it goes. Has anybody seen Pi's latest video?
Yeah. It's a really cool concept. But the box is showing.
Would you use it for anything? I was never in the situation where I thought it would be nice if a flying machine wouldn't break if I unloaded.
Maybe a reload proof pumpkin farm or something?
Yeah, but. Then the pumpkin farm gets a lot more complicated.
Yeah, okay.
It's definitely interesting here. Pi always has those out of the box ideas that nobody else thinks of.
Wasn't it also Pi that introduced TNT tubing with Slamp?
There was actually a group of people that worked on it the same time.
Okay.
Well, 1000 bits by DirtDev. He says, thanks for all your videos, Domingo. Thanks a lot for 1000 bits.
That's cool.
Yeah. What a guy.
And Jayman has no chills.
I think I forgot his 10 bits from earlier. Yeah. Sorry,
yep,
Jayman.
That as well. That's why you got another joke.
You guys are
no
the worst.
Platypus, for once I didn't make a pun. Sorry to let you down.
I hate falling down. Sorry. I always fall down.
Ah.
I mean, definitely beat the pun counter with my fall down counter.
Ooh. Is that a challenge?
Yeah. Ah, there we go again.
Time to stretch a bit and ramp up the puns.
No.
Man, but at that pace it's getting difficult.
Yeah, but it pays off.
Oh.
Oh my gosh.
Mango, do you want a fly landing crash course?
No, it's okay. I'm just gonna place all the pistons.
And
it seems lower.
That punts are my realm.
What again? Reku?
Punts are my realm, not yours.
Okay.
On the other hand, the more the better!
I'm gonna place all the pistons. It's probably better. I have to really focus and then I can't even reach it.
Panic?
Yes.
Do you know what this is?
Wait, let me teleport. Yes, I know what it is. That's the new version of the peaceful mob switch that Methods did.
Oh.
Because he had problems, I think, with floating points.
It was actually Oreo that forgot to remove his warp, but it loaded the chunk.
Oh, okay. So Methods doesn't build the new one here.
Okay. No, it's okay.
Okay.
Panic,
thanks,
German.
Teleport
me.
Yeah.
This one's really cool. Holy fuck, those parents, what the
fuck? What?
Yeah, I think Methods had the idea to use parrots inside cauldrons to move them over the chunk border. No, I think the old one isn't even here. No, that's all after didn't work.
Yeah, well, too bad.
We should probably kill those parrots because I load them every time I'm in my testing area here. It's several hundred mobs in here.
What?
What again?
The pigs as
yeah.
Well.
Yeah, they're probably a good idea to kill those.
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, boy. Who cares about lag on the creative server, really? But yeah, at least not.
Yeah, it's gonna drag this.
Can endermites fit cauldrons? Yes. But there's also despawn after 2 minutes. Oops, done. Oh, my left pinky fingers are hurting from all the control pushing.
Do you always use Forge?
Yeah.
Okay.
Only for Schematica?
Yeah. I guess that won't be a problem, so.
I think Hobby Klein has no option to select a different key for that, right?
It does.
Okay.
But you. Yeah. At least the newer versions do.
Mm-hmm.
But if you don't use Forge, there's a vanilla bug, or actually it's confirmed behavior. So like if you have multiple things bound to the same key, you press that key, it'll only activate one of them.
Okay. That was a question. Will you finish and start the quarry in a special stream? This is gonna be really tricky because we likely make a lot of mistakes while building a quarry, and we need to start it, debug it, fix all the mistakes, try it again and so on. So the stream wouldn't be fun because then we need to load a backup of the whole world again, which takes 15 minutes, and what are they gonna do in between? That is probably not good material for a stream, sorry.
I think we can make a bit of a compilation out of it or something.
Maybe, yeah.
That might be more suited.
So the 360 quarry, I think we spent like 6 hours from the first try of starting it until we said, okay, now it's kind of working. And in between, not much happened. It was always like 50 minutes waiting for the backup of the world. Hmm.
Did you use Schematica for that?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Still made a lot of mistakes.
Yeah, of course. My quarry crashed 2 days after I started it. We placed everything correctly except one observer that wasn't in the schematic because I had to replace it. And that one observer was wrong, of course.
shoot, it didn't finish before 9.
Oh nein!
There we go, 10 seconds. Kinda glad that it's done for the day at least. Okay, but it was good progress. 3 layers in 3 hours. Pretty sweet. Why did you try the machine on a backup to start with? We're definitely gonna do that, and then we have to load that backup still a lot of times. Could maybe try to extract maybe the world files or the region files for that. Thanks for the 100 bits after 11. It says, thanks for streaming, El Mango. Have a great day. Yeah, you too. Thanks a lot, everybody, for streaming, for watching. As always, I'm gonna search for somebody else to raid. Or Ray was a suggestion?
Give me a heads warning before. No streaming again, but since he was kinda confused yesterday, let's...
Hypno.
let's check if there's someone else.
I just wanna say that next Wednesday, 6 PM, it's the next Mesa Quarry stream, so at least once a week we're gonna work on it, just to get it finished.
So there's a Russian streamer called Imauzo.
Yeah, but Russian is maybe
yeah, of
not
course. Just find the name people, funny.
A lot of people suggest this Zuma.
He's streaming?
Apparently.
Yeah, then go ahead.
Okay. Yeah, I just want to say that my next stream is probably Friday.
Something else.
Okay. I have to open my browser. Yeah. It's gonna take a while.
I don't have all my social media stuff open. Let's get home.
Our French streamer once. We already raided IPR once, so we did that. One moment, I have to open my browser.
Yeah, we're gonna raid Zuma, but Mango needs some time to log in and, you
yeah,
know.
We're gonna raid Zuma, but
Mango needs some time to log in.
There we go.
Got it. The issue was I wanted to mute my browser and then clicked on close by accident. Took a bit longer, sorry. Okay, then, yeah.
Guess that button was too close.
I found nowhere it's Zuma's. See you next time. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Huldigt ihm!